This is another picture that every time it flashes up sends chills. Okay. Should be here. He should be here. Here's your update. Cop City activist who was shot and killed by police January 18th had his hands in the air. That according to a second independent autopsy into the death. Manuel Esteban Paez Teran, 26-year-old, who went by the nickname Tortuguita, meaning little turtle. Civil rights attorneys Brian Spears, Jeff Filipovitz hosted a news conference this morning to discuss their lawsuit and the autopsy results. The attorneys filed that suit against the city of Atlanta on Friday. They complained they have not received additional body cam footage of the shooting as promised by the city after the GBI, the Georgia Bureau of Investigations, intervened to prevent the footage's release. GBI has selectively released information about Manny's death. They claim Manny failed to follow orders. What orders? GBI has not talked about the fact that Manny faced a firing squad when those shots were fired or who fired them. Body cam footage released so far. Many bullets can be heard but not seen. Here's one officer approaching a tent in the woods with his gun drawn. In the video, officers express confusion over who fired first and ask if police were firing at each other when this young man was killed. The GBI denied the officer's statement in a release on February 9th. In an obit posted to one of the activist groups Tortuguita belonged to, a friend of the activist posted, quote, "I will never cease to be amazed by their tireless activism, their extreme empathy, and their ability to make everyone feel welcome in radical spaces." Tortuguita was staying in the woods to protest the construction of a military-style training complex for police, locally called Cop City, because of course we need another Cop City, don't we? We need another one. Tortuguita is alive in our hearts. My prayer is that the blood of my son will speak in all of our hearts. We are going to win. Is this winnable, Jackson? When even this young person who believed in the environment and loving others is gunned down in this way and lied on after he's gone?
I think in the long run, change is possible, but in the short run, I don't think anything's going to change with this Cop City. Because unless there's a force that's powerful enough to shut them down, why would they shut down? I mean, Tortuguita was one of the most non-threatening looking people that you could have seen. On top of the fact that these officers weren't in danger, they have all the firepower, they have resources behind them, and they have the support of the state and the city behind them. So there was absolutely no reason for them to do this whatsoever. And unfortunately, all they were doing is protecting their interests, protecting their assets, and protecting their authority, most importantly. But again, in the long run, I think change is possible. But just the law enforcement system at large is very complicated. It's interconnected, but also it runs on municipalities. So you can change something in one state or one city and then not change in another one. So again, this is going to be a grassroots effort that's going to take a very long time. But this is a story of civilization and humanity. Endless fighting, we make progress, we make change, and it never stops. But that's what keeps us going.
Tortuguita's death, their death, to me, points out something else. The statements in the aftermath of the shooting, where bullets are just flying, these officers had extensive training. They had training. A military style training complex, Cop City. How would that have helped this situation? They're firing so many bullets. It is shocking that they did not gun down one of their own. The bumbling, just going in, shooting. At what? A tent, as we saw in the one body cam angle that was released here, and the GBI saying that, you know, I can demean your character after you're gone, but I can't release more body cam footage. I can say you didn't follow orders, but I won't tell you what those orders are. Doesn't this, what we know so far, Jackson, support the fact that no amount of training is going to stop this cycle of violence perpetuated by more gangs in uniform? I'm sorry.
Yeah, I mean, knowing how to kill someone isn't going to prevent you from doing it. That's essentially what we're talking about. And at the end of the day, if there's no larger consequences or repercussions, then as you pointed out, this won't change. Because if you have the authority to take a life and there aren't consequences for you doing it, naturally, you're going to cross those boundaries. You're going to cross those lines because that's how people work. But yes, I mean, training, you can train them up. But at the end of the day, it's who you're hiring. Why are these people in these positions? What kind of backgrounds do they have? Oftentimes, police officers have very disturbing backgrounds of domestic violence and things along those lines. They never should have gotten the job in the first place. The standards need to be raised on who can even work there. So much needs to happen. But one of the more important things is there have to be larger consequences to pay. That's where we have to start.
Yeah. When you pal around with other people who perhaps hold similar values or life experiences, no wonder there's perceived and real collusion involved here. Thank goodness this family is lawyered up and doing an independent autopsy to refute what too often is the lie.